Alright, let's go. You've gained your first companions. They will follow the last cast-off and can be controlled during a crisis. You can speak to them about their past and take advantage of their unique abilities and skills. Companions have their own motivations and personalities, and depending on the choices you make, they may not follow you forever. You will find more companions who can join you as you travel through the Ninth World. Take this opportunity to explore your surroundings. You may find items, equipment, and more to assist you. When you are ready, you can leave the Broken Dome using the stairs to the northeast. Okay. Let's look around. And then see if we can talk to them some more about other things.
On it.
A mechanical arm lies on the floor, presumably broken during your fall. Sparks pour from the arm's shattered housing, filling the air with a greasy stench. First, let's examine the housing. The sharply pointed apparatus that formerly topped the device appears burnt out and useless, but the equipment in the base remains at least somewhat operational, as the constant stream of sizzling motes can attest. Okay, so we're going to use... I don't think we have quick fingers, but we have lore machinery. So let's attempt to scavenge what we can from the arm's housing. Okay, effort. Companions cannot assist in a crisis, and they can only use their stats during their turn. Oops. Taking care to avoid the sparks, you extract several handfuls of shiny trinkets and coin-like objects. Awesome. You recognize their value as once such objects would be accepted as shins, the informal currency in most regions of the world, so you gather them up and take them with you. Huh. We gained a spray flash thing? Usable. Heals 8 points of health. Oh, cool. This tiny synth canister sprays a sticky gelatinous substance. This gelatin covers and seals wounds instantaneously if applied correctly. Awesome! It's metagel. Sparks angrily leap to and fro amidst several cables and other broken components. Okay, cool.
Let's go.
Here's our, resonance chamber. Sunlight falls through the ragged hole in the roof onto the shattered resonance chamber. It is hard to believe that you did this, that you plummeted through the curve of the pale blue sky, crashed through the dome, and broke this delicate machine with your own body. It's hard to believe you are still alive. 4 mechanical arms hang over the center of the device, above the cracked, semi-transparent crystal of the sarcophagus. The 5th arm lies broken on the floor, among the scattered synth and crystal shards, and a metal ring surrounds the array, dented and broken by your impact crater. Let's take a closer look at the sarcophagus. The padded interior beneath the coffin's cracked lid looks like it was made for a human body. Despite the damage, you don't see any way to open it and get inside. You glance between the sarcophagus and the needle-like protrusions at the ends of the arms above. It seems likely that using this chamber would not be a pleasant experience. Let's examine the shards on the ground. Jagged fragments of crystal are intermingled with synth from the shattered dome above. The crystal shards glitter in the light like captive suns. Let's pick one up. Cool. We got a crystalline shard. At the rim of the crater you find a sliver of crystal, sharp as a dagger on one end and smooth on the other. It might make a usable, if somewhat crude, weapon. Okay, so 2 physical damage, plus 2 damage per effort applied, max plus 6. Light weapon bonus, plus 15%. You scavenge this crystalline shard from the wreckage... Okay, so we've already equipped it. That's cool. From the wreckage of the Changing God's resonance chamber, it is sharp and can serve as an improvised weapon. Okay. Let's examine the suspended... Look for other useful shards here. You sort through the remaining pieces of crystal, but they're too small or too unwieldy to be of any use. Let's examine the suspended arms. cables run from machines along the dome's walls to the base of the suspended arms, each of which is capped with long needles aimed at the cracked coffin-like chamber at the center of the platform. Gem-like lights flicker dimly at the bases of the arms. The needle-like extensions at the ends of the arm glitter in the dome's faint light. A number of the lights at the bases of the arms have gone out. And the sarcophagus, it may be your imagination, but some of the cracks in the crystal seem shallower than they were before. Let's inspect the metal ring. You feel the slightest hint of resistance every time you cross the ring, and now that you're paying attention, you note that your breath is echoing in your ears as though you were inside a glass dome. When you step outside the ring, the feeling passes. So is our lower machinery. You kneel to inspect a broken section and take note of the field projectors inside. They are omnidirectional. The ring exists to protect anyone standing inside it, but also to contain tremendous amounts of power. The ring seems to project some kind of field, like a protective dome around the sarcophagus. Okay. What's this?
Yes.
Oh, yes. What we got? We have shins. 11 shins. Encephalic rush. This pliable synth container is tightly sealed, holding a swirling purple gas. The purple substance is harvested from a vast structure buried beneath the sands of the beyond, which seems to constantly replenish, though it is hard to gather. If the container is jammed hard against the surface, it becomes permeable, unleashing the gas within. The original purpose of the gas is not known, but when inhaled by a human being, it provides a rush of mental energy. Cool. Okay. Heals 3 points of intellect. The TLDR here. And this is a Fleetfoot moss, which heals 3 points of speed. This moss-covered pebble looks almost ordinary, and if it were lying on the ground, it would be difficult to spot. But the moss shifts in unexpected ways, and the pebble vibrates as it does. If held against the skin, the moss latches on and is absorbed, providing powerful resuscitating energies. These pebbles are found by diving into the waters around Sega's cliffs, perhaps grown by an unknown interaction with the surrounding Numenera. Take all. Yeah.
Fine.
A slate black, unimpressive device hunkers before you. As you reach out to touch it, the triangle of lights on its casing blazes into life, and an image unfolds in your mind. A towering crystal arch rises over a jagged gray landscape. The air is dead and stifling, and there, at its emerald peak, the image collapses, leaving you staring into the device's triangular array of lights. Command me. The device, or the intelligence within it, says, each word carefully etched with distaste. Really? Who are you? Your command was not understood, the intelligence says with clear satisfaction, sounding for all the world like it understood the question, but is choosing not to answer. Command me. What was that arch you showed me? Your command was not understood. The intelligence chuckles, its lights pulsing. Command me. What commands do you recognize? The three lights throb irritably. Heated air sighs from the device's vents, and then a towering list of commands races through your mind, far too fast to read. You rub your eyes, groaning, and the intelligence chortles. Command me, it says smugly. Okay. So the DIR, you know, for people who know MS-DOS, the DIR, all the files flash back way too quickly. We need DIR/P. Oh, I'm not gonna kick the thing. Show me that list of commands again. Slower, please. If anything, the list pours through your mind even faster than the last time. Command me, the intelligence drawls. Show me that arch again. The The device's triangle of lights throb in time with the growl of the energies within its casing, and the mental image unfolds once more. You see a huge crystalline arch on a jagged field. The arch is divided into rectangular cells, all of which are numbered, and they all appear to be transparent and empty, except at the arch's pinnacle, one cell is lit in a brilliant, pulsating emerald. The number 0, looks like an O, is printed on its side. This thing is hilarious, by the way. Or it's this thing. It really doesn't want to help us. Let's use anamnesis, whatever the hell that is. Try to remember more details about this strange place. We can only go that high. Apparently, success, yeah. The memory blossoms. You stand before this arch, eyeing the last two active cells in once impenetrable Lugum Vo. Unleash cell 29, you say, and a twisted artifact appears before you. You claim it with a faint smile, watching the light fade from the cell far above. You flinch from the memory, and it falls apart as you raise your eyes to the arch as it is now. Cell 29 is dark now. Only cell 0 remains. Let's examine the jagged wasteland. Dry grit whirls across the empty plain. Many kilometers beyond the arch is the faint outline of what seems to be a broken tower, except that it is slowly stretching into the gray air. Far beyond the arch, the broken tower reaches for pale, red-threaded clouds. Okay, close. You release your mental hold on the image of the arch, and it collapses, returning you to reality. Command me, the intelligence says sulkily. Let's examine the outside of the device. An indignant hum rises from the intelligence's engines as you examine its ancient casing. A much newer mechanism on the device's side appears to be giving this intelligence its vocabulary and forcing it to speak to you. The device's original creator may not have meant for it to communicate at all. I don't want to smash it. Unleash the contents of cell 0. You found a cipher. Ciphers are Numenera objects that can trigger a powerful effect, but can only be used once. Huh. Ciphers and your cipher limit score are displayed in a special section of your inventory screen. Yes, I've seen that. Take care not to accumulate more ciphers than your cipher limit, or you will experience unpleasant side effects. The device's lights flutter with incandescent shock, then focus on you, flickering. Cell 0 will now be unleashed, the intelligence spits. Please be advised that the object you are about to receive is completely safe. Use no caution whatsoever. I don't think I trust this thing. The strange contents of cell 0 materialize before you. Warning, all cells are now vacant. Shuddering Lugum Vo. The intelligence's lights wink out one by one. So we gain an item for unstable detonation. Allegorin says, interesting that a cast-off can command the Changing God's machines. He crosses his arms across his chest. How'd you do that? Kalistez rolls her eyes at Allegorin, then she looks to you. He'll never stop gnawing on his bone, you know. The truth is wasted on him. She gets a glint in her eye. Though I admit curiosity, how did you do that? I remembered something. I knew it, Allegorin says, bearing a savagely triumphant grin at Kalistage. Meaningless, Allegorin. She clearly has basic skills and knowledge from the Changing God having been in her body. Who's to say there aren't even more specific memories locked away in there? And she thinks, how many memories might this child have access to? I must know. Crackle.
On it.
It just crackles.
Sure.
Ready.
Okay.
Yes.
What's this thing? Tiny glowing motes float through the interior of this tower. Each one is surrounded by much smaller motes, like thousands of worlds circling their suns. Like little nano things. Anything else I can look at? The flexible tubes that are attached to this machine appear to be later additions. Someone cobbled the device together, but its function is unclear. Now, I think if I hit tab... Aha. Oh, there's something over here. Broken fragments of the dome ceiling are scattered on the floor. They appear to be made of transparent synth.
Let's go.
Yeah, that doesn't do anything now. This thing looks interesting, though. Okay, I guess that's it.
We should not tarry in this chamber long. No doubt others saw your dramatic entrance as well.
Cool.
I don't like the smell of this dome. Let's go. Sooner, not later.
I really like the voice acting so far. Okay.
What do you need?
I need to look at your goods. What's his name again? Allegern. He has a mace. 4 physical damage. No active fennels. So this is a cipher thing we picked up. Unstable detonation. All in immediate area. Deals 6 energy damage, 4 physical damage to all characters in range. A simple and effective explosive. Devices like these have been the bane of many who've had the misfortune of encountering them. Cobbled together from junk and Numenera, this detonation can have wild and unexpected effects when hurled at the enemy. Rumors have it that most of the unlucky victims of these devices were the people trying to use them, for their instability makes them just as dangerous to their owners as to their enemies. Okay, so in our backpack we've got these goodies we picked up. We've got 26 shins. Shiny coin-like objects treated as currency in the Ninth World. So we've got the crystalline shard. I guess, what happened to that mirror thing? I guess we lost that. The mirror thing we picked up in the calm. Will-woven garnet. Garment, sorry. 3 resistance only usable by the last cast-off. This silky garment barely feels even lighter than it looks. Of course, that's not really surprising. You made this armor with your decisions. It is woven entirely from your thoughts, given shape by your intent, and it will protect you as you fight your enemies as a nano does, from afar, using your superior intellect and esoteries. As fragile as the entire affair appears, you sense a humming field of energy clinging to it that will increase the connection speed between your brain synapses while passively repelling incoming attacks. All in all, it's an impressive set of armor. You have quite the imagination, it seems. So this thing is powered by my imagination. That's pretty freaking awesome, I think. So he's got... This vest belongs to Allegern. It doesn't offer much protection to his arms, but is made of a material tough and thick enough to absorb glancing blows. So it's 1 armor and 2 resistance. Cannot be unequipped. His coat gives him plus 15% willpower. Allegern's dusty leather coat has seen long years of use. Pockets line its surface, and a latticework of wires covers over a strange star on the jacket's breast. And his mace. This mace has a slender haft attached to a heavy flanged head that can tear into heavy armor. Maces are cheap, common, easy to create. So I guess everyone has... Yes, everyone has that money. 26 shins. Okay, and Calistage. Well, she's a cunning nano who pierces realities. Huh. Callistash has gathered esoterics and knowledge from countless realities. She is truly a force to be reckoned with. Okay, so she wants to learn about us. I want to learn what she knows. And Allegrin is a hardened nano who fights with his demons. So we've got all nanos here. We need a tank. What the hell? Callistash's dress. One armor, two resistance. This colorful, elegant dress belongs to Callistash. Endless copies of the same dress belong to her sisters. Her cloak is a dimensional mantle, plus 10% willpower. You occasionally see flashes of a cloth material similar to Callistash's dress shimmering around her form. It appears to be some kind of connective tissue between her and her echoes. She's got a buzzer, which is a light ranged weapon. So apparently, what's his name? Allegern is going to be the tank out of all of us. 3 physical damage, plus 2 damage per effort applied. Max is plus 6. Light weapon bonus plus 15%. This small mechanical device fits comfortably in a human hand. It fires thumbnail-sized razor-sharp discs. While these devices are sometimes made from scavenged Numenera, skilled artisans can craft them from raw parts. They're fairly common weapons, though still valued and dangerous. Okay, so what about character sheet? So I don't have anything I can read about him. He has living tattoos. Very much reminds me of Planescape Torment. Callistash. Cutting down. So he's a hardened nano, so he's gonna be the tank. Not much of a tank, but at least he's hardened, right? Callistash has transdimensional onslaught. Deals 5 transdimensional damage. So that's a type of damage. Transdimensional. Confers hobbled if the target fails to resist. Dimensional superposition. Teleport to a point within range, then gain phased. Converts all damage to transdimensional and grants plus 30% evasion, plus 3 resistance, except transdimensional. Damage dealt to this character is 100%. So she's got the concentration and the cipher limit. Targeting eye. Gain plus 15% on esoteric attacks. A mechanical enhancement to your biological eye helps you focus your more esoteric attacks. That's cool. So she's got concentration, lore, mystical, and perception. And he has concentration, cipher use, endurance, lore machinery, and smashing. So if we want something smashed, turn to him. And of course, here's ours. Fallen to Earth. So we have one quest, main quest. I miraculously survived a fall from many kilometers above the Earth's surface, only to find myself in another unexpected situation. My only hope of stopping the sorrow, the creature that hunts me, is to climb inside the crystal resonance chamber and activate the device. Unfortunately, the resonance chamber was badly damaged by my fall, so it'll need to be fixed. So find a way to repair the resonance chamber. The two people who found me have conflicting opinions about where I should go for help. Allegern suggested I speak with the cultist of the Changing God, while Callistash directed me to the Order of Truth. Okay, we're going to be looking for the Order of Truth, I think, so far. So what's all this? Party inventory. Character sheet. Oh, it's just in different ways. Area map. Broken dome. Crystal sarcophagus. AKA resonance chamber. So that's point of interest, is this. And here's us. Pretty awesome. So, next episode, guys, will be leaving for... Does it even say on the map what this is? We'll be leaving for the Reef of Fallen Worlds. Can't wait. As it is, I played for like an hour and 45 minutes with my voice like this. Because I'm not sure if I could even save before. Well, after I finished talking to them, when I came here, I could. But I just wanted to finish looking around this chamber first. So really awesome. I'm intrigued. I really am. Cool. Can't wait to play more. Hope my voice comes back soon. Thanks so much for watching, guys. And enduring, grow strong.